Climate change is one of the biggest challenges of today, and industrial companies are required more than ever to work on solutions to reduce CO2 output. We are convinced that digitalization of hydraulics plays a huge role in this topic and have put this under the headline of connected hydraulics. But what's the role of connected hydraulics to reach more sustainability, and what's the role of additive manufacturing in this whole thing? I'm Johannes Suess, Product Manager for Industrial Manifolds, and I would like to talk about this topic with you today. In connected hydraulics, we've got three levers for sustainability. One would be less energy. Second one, less fluid. And the third one, less material. And less material is what we want to talk about today on the example of an industrial manifold, as it is shown here, in a conventional fashion. And on the other side, over here, we have the same manifold manufactured with additive manufacturing methods. That's what we want to go into detail about today. In industrial hydraulics, we do have two methods for additive manufacturing. One would be direct metal printing, or SLM. And the other one is the one shown here today, is 3D sand core printing, where we use a negative of the manifold printed out of sand to cast a manifold then with all the properties of additive manufacturing. And this technology we've been doing for quite a long time already in our foundry, and have also applied this to manifolds quite a few times already. And first, before I go into the properties of this technology, I would like to discuss a little bit about how this sand core manifold comes into place in the first place. Yeah, so in the beginning, it all starts with the design process, similar as with the conventional manifold. However, as we do have advanced options in 3D sand core printing, for example, the internal channel design, you can see it here in those, let's say, banana-shaped channels on the inside. And we use CFD, computational fluid dynamics, to design those. And after design, it goes into the printer. In the printer, we create this sand core in layers of 280 micrometers. And then afterwards, it's just conventional casting and some slight machining. Machining for two things. One would be for threads, and the other one would be for sealing surfaces. And then we're done. Then we've got the conventional manifold replaced by a manifold made out of 3D sand core printing. For additive manufacturing, oftentimes the question is, where's the benefit? What's in it for me? We've identified the five major points that are benefits of this process. And one, of course, would be geometry. Yeah? Different geometry, easier to put into the machine. Second would be function integration. If I have an easier machine integration, it's easier to integrate other functions, bigger components onto the manifold. Third, weight. Quite obvious. Looking at the cutouts that we have on the manifold, of course, we don't put the material there, so therefore we save weight. The fourth one would be no more screw plugs, as we don't have to use auxiliary holes to have the rectangular connections within the manifold. We don't need any screw plugs to close those auxiliary holes. One thing I want to mention is, of course, we have a screw plug here on the front, but this is because there's a valve behind it. And last but not least, of course, the topic of the improved energy efficiency. And this one, oftentimes we get the question, yeah, but let's go into detail. What's in it? What do we save? What energy do we save? And this is what we want to talk about today. And of course, also the question, does it pay off? And if so, when? Before we go into this, first, let's have a look at the life cycle of the manifold. And let's exclude for a short while the machine running, but rather really the production, the transport, and also the recycling of the manifold. I've mentioned it already with those cutouts. We don't have to put any material there. And material we don't have to put there. We don't have to melt. We don't have to cast. We don't need it. And this is where we already have quite the leverage. There we save roughly, in this case, 50 kilograms of material, roughly a third of the overall manifold weight. And this weight we save, the material we don't use, translates into 130 kilograms of CO2 not emitted. And to make it a little bit more tangible, those 130 kilograms translate into roughly 1,000 kilometers of a car ride, or if you use the manifold in a small series, roughly 1 year of heating your apartment. Not too bad, I would say. But now, I think more relevant to you, because you can really touch it in your machine, what does it save when the machine is running? I mentioned it. We've used CFD to optimize the inner channel geometries to reduce pressure losses. And This specific machine runs 3,000 hours per year, and in those 3,000 hours we save about 750 kilowatt hours of energy that we don't have to put into the manifold. This translates into roughly 450 kilograms of CO2, and again, to make it tangible, roughly 3,000 kilometers of car ride, or about three and a half years of heating your apartment. Also not too bad. One thing I believe you might say now as well, yeah, 750 kilowatt hours, that's not too much in the overall picture. Now we say, yeah, might be true, but one thing that's important in looking at sustainability and energy efficiency is system design. So if you look at your system, all the single components need to play a role and need to put their benefits into the whole system. And this is what we can do besides Cytronics for the drives and so on, also with those manifolds. With this future-proof solution, we are supporting you in regards to more sustainability. Feel free to get in touch with our local Rexford colleagues, look onto our website or in the video description below for more information. Thanks for having me today and goodbye.